Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I'm going to talk to you just a little bit about which herbs you should be taking. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Chelsea Knutsen and I'm a certified holistic health coach, and I help women shrink fibroids and heal womb issues using food, herbs, and God's word as medicine. Let me get right into this topic. Which herbs should you be taking? And I'm just specifically talking about the herbs from my herbal store. And I'm just going to talk about a few things, the things that I think are most popular. If you have any kind of womb issue, like fibroids, cysts, endometriosis, polyps, anything womb related or ovary related or pelvic related in that area, vagina related, and you want to remove that inflammation and move that congestion out of your vagina area. It could be HPV, it could be pelvic inflammatory disease, it could be any of those things. The tea that you would want to take is the A New Creation Womb Healing Tea, and I'll put a picture of it right here. That's the tea that I think will help that area, because it has herbs in it that help remove cysts, tumors, inflammation, pelvic congestion. That's what the herbs do in that particular blend. So if you're struggling with hormonal imbalance, skin issues, things like that, then the liver cleanser would be a good option for that. Because what that liver cleanser will do is help to metabolize the excess hormones that you have floating in your body that is causing your body to be out of balance. And also it has hormone balancing herbs in that tea blend. So that would be perfect for somebody in that condition. So next is, if you are somebody who is bleeding heavy, like you are like, you know, every month you're bleeding, there's two formulas I recommend. And the first one is the Bye-Bye Anemia. So you can help to replace the blood in your body, help replace the iron in your body. And secondly, you want to take the bleeding formula. So there is two ways for you to take the bleeding formula. One is you take it every day as general maintenance. If like, so for example, if you know you're somebody who bleeds heavy, and bleeding heavy is bleeding more than 2 to 3 tablespoons of blood during your entire menstrual cycle. That's if you have more blood than that, then that's too much blood. So you would take it on a daily basis according to the package directions, just to kind of rein that bleeding in. And then what you would do is, if you're having your menstrual cycle and you're having like these hemorrhaging fits, then you want to take the herbal blend, the bleeding formula, every hour on the hour until the bleeding stops or slows down. So that's how you take that product. But basically, the Bye-Bye Anemia and the bleeding formula go hand in hand for somebody who has the issue with the blood. If you're somebody who has like vaginal discharge, odor, yeast infections, things like that, then the best tea for you is the Healthy Vagina Tea. That tea is going to go in and help reduce that odor, get rid of the things in your vagina that are causing that problem. And also, whenever you have this type of problem, it's actually also pointing to your gut. So it means that your diet has not been the best over the years, and maybe you're starting to change it now, but you need to keep on doing it. Because you need to keep on working on your gut, because the problem in your gut, meaning like your gut microbiome or the condition of your gut because of the foods that you ate over the years hasn't been the healthiest, it's not the healthiest bacteria in your gut. So you have to keep on eating the healthy food so that you can change the way that bacteria is. And that Healthy Vagina Tea not only helps the vagina, but it also helps the gut, because it has herbs in it that will help the gut. So also, when you start taking that one, and it is a pretty nasty tea, it's like very bitter, but you want it to be bitter because it has the herbs in it that's going to help with clearing that problem up that you have in your gut and in your vagina. And not only that, sometimes you can feel worse down there while taking that tea, and then you'll feel better because what happens is it draws that stuff out. So, and some women, they're like, it feels worse. Well, it may feel worse, but it will get better. Just stay consistent with the product so that you can experience the beauty on the other side. The other thing that I ask people to take along with that is the coconut oil that I sell on my site. It is not like any other coconut oil that I've ever used before. And if you have itchiness, odor, all that stuff, and you just put some of that in your vagina or in you know, on your lips and inside your insides of your vagina, it helps curb the itching, the odor. It helps curb, helps you to feel better if you're not feeling down there. That stuff is miraculous. I don't know what this coconut oil is in comparison to the others, but it has to be that the quality and the way they make it or process it has to be the key, because I've used many coconut oils and nothing I have used is like the one that I sell on my website. I haven't experienced it, and I've had many women tell me that coconut oil is fantastic. So couple the coconut oil with the healthy vagina tea. The next tea is, if you're somebody who's getting a lot of menstrual cramps, I have a formula that is called No More Cramps, and it has herbs in it that helps reduce or stop the painful menstrual cycles that you might be going through. It's a fantastic blend. It is, and if you take some and you simmer it for a minute, or even just soak it overnight or whatever, if you know that your period is coming and you know you normally get cramps, be ready for it. Just be drinking it to get rid of the inflammation in your body. Next tea is the lymphatic formula. So I love the lymphatic formula because our lymphatic system is the system in our body that is our sewer system. And most people, their sewer system isn't moving properly and it's toxic. And the reason that most people's sewer system is toxic is because of what we eat, what we drink, what we think, all this stuff, the same reason you get fibroids, all that. And you can hear that conversation in other videos. But the reason why the sewer system is so toxic is because it is the only system, like the circulatory system, like your blood system, it has a pump on it. Like your heart is beating every day and it moves your blood throughout your body to nourish your trillions of cells, right? But the lymphatic system is a sewer system, and if the only way that it's going to move is if we exercise. But if also our eliminative channels are toxic and clogged up, it has no way to escape. So the lymphatic fluid, the lymphatic formula, what it does is it helps move the toxins out of your cells, out of your body, into your urine, into your urine and into your colon so you can excrete it. Also, the lymphatic system moves things out through your skin if you sweat. So if you are one of these people who are afraid to sweat, please stop doing that, because you're doing your body a disservice. You need to sweat every day. If you can sweat from head to toe every day, that would be great. Like, that's why saunas are fantastic. Like the infrared sauna is one of the tools that I used to get well years ago. I was at my sickest. I loved my sauna, and my lymphatic system was a nightmare, and the sauna helped me to get well. So I will sing the praises of saunas, because God showed me that, and I was just kind of like, it was a game changer for me. Not saying you need a sauna to heal, not saying that at all, but what I'm saying is when I learned how to move my lymphatic system, that's what changed it. And sweating, exercise, and herbs, and rebounding. I love rebounding too. Rebounding was one of the other things that helped me. And not all rebounders are created equal either. I will put a link to the rebounder that I absolutely love down here in the description box too. I've had it since 2013 and it was a game changer for me for getting well as well. You don't need a rebounder to get well either. It's just another option or a tool that you can use for your toolbox. But anyway, but the lymphatic system tea helps to move the herbs, help to move the backed up lymphatic fluid out of your body. The next tea that you'll see on my site is the stinging nettle tea. I love stinging nettles. I take stinging nettles all the time. Like, there are things that stinging nettles does for the body that I don't even know what it does. And it just makes me feel even better whenever I drink it. So what I typically will do is whatever blend I'm drinking that day is I'll just put some stinging nettle in there because I think it's fantastic. And in most of my blends, it does have some stinging nettle in it because I just think it's so fantastic, but there's nothing wrong with adding a little bit more. That or elderberry because they're both fantastic. So many benefits to the both of them, but the reason I'm even talking about either one of those is because it's the unseen or the unspoken things that the stinging nettle and the elderberry do when you add it to your other tea blends. It just helps. It helps you feel even better than you thought you could. That's my experience. I can't say that that's how everybody feels, but that's how I feel about it. And next one is mullein tea. I don't take mullein very often, but I'm gonna tell you, I probably should. Even though I've been done a lot of cleansing in my life and a lot of healing and all that stuff, I used to smoke a lot of cigarettes, like a lot. I smoked probably more than a pack a day for 17 years. I quit smoking in 2005, and I'm so grateful that I was able to quit. But I don't know that my lungs, even though they say that over a couple years your lungs are pink and all that stuff again, but I still think that it's possible that, you know, when you smoke all those cigarettes that you need to do some type of cleansing, and mullein is one of those that you can use to cleanse your lungs. Also, if you've been a weed smoker, some people think that weed smoking is healthy. I'm sorry, I hate to tell you, but why would weed smoking be healthy? Like, you're bringing smoke into your lungs, and most of this weed that people are smoking, it has chemicals on it and everything that the farmers are putting on it to make it grow faster. Just like some of the food that's in the supermarket, they're, you know, the chemicals that they're using, it's the same thing. And then you go smoke the weed thinking it's healthy, and then, you know, you're smoking the chemicals too. Now, I know I probably ruffled some feathers here, but that's okay. We can, you know, we can agree to disagree, but I'm just telling you what my opinion is about this stuff. And if you've been a weed smoker, a cigarette smoker, mullein tea is going to help you to get rid of that stuff. And even if you're just the type of, even if you've never smoked in your life, but you've got a lot of mucus in your body, in like in your lungs or in your body in general, the mullein is going to help move that out. So hopefully that's been helpful. And the last two teas I want to talk about is the sleepy time tea and the grow my hair tea. If you're having issues with hair loss, alopecia, hair thinning, balding, this is a great tea to drink on a regular basis. I have hair and I cut it because I wanted it cut into a shape. I didn't cut it because I was having a problem. I cut it and look how healthy my hair looks. It's nice and shiny. You know what I mean? Nice shiny hair. And what used to happen is if I touched my hair, I would have a handful of hair. When I wash my hair, I would have a handful of hair. When I wash my hair, it's like a little, about that much hair comes off in the thing. And I wash my hair about once every, these days, since it's shorter, I wash it like once every week-ish. Like maybe I might go 9 days instead of 7, but I like to go 6 or 7 days. But anyway, and I love that tea. It's gonna give you minerals and it's got herbs in it that help support your hair. And lastly, the sleepy time tea. If you're having trouble sleeping, sleepy time tea is going to help to relax you so that you can get into a place where you can sleep well. Lastly, this is the last thing I'm gonna talk to you about, but that was the last tea that I wanna discuss. There is no magic bullet. These teas were designed to help you, but they weren't designed to go past like your unhealthy lifestyle. You have to either start doing something right for your lifestyle for these teas to do something, or you need to be on your program and then add these as a supplement to you doing the right thing with your health. So hopefully this has been helpful to you. I really do hope it has been, because the reason that I created the Herbal Blends store is because There just wasn't something out there that was catering to women the way I needed them to, based on the demographic of women that I have been working with. So that's why I created it. And I've prayed over these formulas, and God gave me the formulas and the things to sell on my site. And so I'm not saying that if you take them, everything is going to be perfect in your life. It could, I don't know, but I do know that they have helped lots of women. And if you are in need of some support with herbs, these are good options for you. But that's all I wanted to share. If no one told you that they love you today, Chelsea in North Carolina loves you very much, and I'll talk to you all soon. Take care.